Hello everyone, and welcome to our yet another discussion for the solution to activity 8.2. And of course, we have just covered our lecture on prior period errors as covered under the International Accounting Standard 8. So in this activity, they are telling us that during 2020, NASA Uganda Limited discovered that certain items had been included in the inventory as at 31st of March 2019. Now, these items of inventory were valued at 4.2 million, which had in fact been sold before the year end. So this is an example of a prior period error where inventories have been included, yet in fact these inventories were sold. So they continue by saying that the following figures for 2019 as reported and 2020 draft are available. So they have given us basically the statement of profit or loss for 2 years, 2019 and 2020. And of course, we have our profit for the year, or profit for the period for that matter. And definitely, if this is my profit or loss, the 2019 financial year will act as the year of comparison. And of course, that one will provide the comparative amounts for the draft financial statement of the year 2020. So they continue by saying that in the additional information, Roman 1, retained earnings at 1st of April 2019 were 13 million. And the cost of goods sold for 2020 include the 4.2 million error. So the error was carried forward to our new year 2020. And then the income tax rate was 30% for 2019 and 2020. And definitely they continue to tell us that in Roman 4 that no dividends have been declared or paid in the financial year. So we are required to show the statement of profit or loss for 2020 with the 2019 comparative and the retained earnings. So of course, in our discussion under the International Accounting Standard 8 on prior period errors, the standard requires that prior period errors should be corrected retrospectively. And of course, this will involve two major treatments. One, the standard requires either we restate the comparative amounts for the prior periods in which the error occurred. And of course, in our case, that's the 2019 prior period comparative figures. Or number two, if the error occurred maybe in 2018 or 2017, what the standard says are periods before the prior period presented, we may restate the opening balances of assets, liabilities and equity for the period so that the financial statements are presented as if the error has never occurred. So of course, in our example, in our activity 8.3, the error actually occurred in the period of comparison, which is 2019. So basically what we shall do, we shall simply restate the prior period statement of profit or loss. All right, so get your pens, get your calculators, and of course your answer sheet so that we may be able to work this out. So assuming that this is my clean sheet here, where I'm going to present my solution. Of course, I'll give my solution a title, and that is Solution to Activity 8.2, NASA Uganda Limited, okay? So we proceed to just give a further title, and that is NASA Uganda Limited, Statement of Profit or Loss for the year ended 31st of March. And definitely I'll need some columns. So I'll need a column to capture my financial year 2019. And of course, that will be our column there. Then of course, I need another column which will capture the amounts for 2020. which is that one there, okay, 2020 and 2019. And then next, I need to rewrite. What I'll do, I'll just get back to my question here. I'll just rewrite the statement as it is, picking items as given to me in the examination. I begin with the sales, then I move to the cost of sales, then I move to the profit before taxation, like that, okay, in that order. So starting with the sales, I bring in the sales in my statement, in a new statement where I'm correcting my error. So of course, the first item is the sales, okay. So according to the information we have, I don't think our sales are affected, okay. Our sales are not affected because the error is not committed within the sales. So we shall capture the figures for sales as they are. We are going to get the 47,400,000, take it to our statement, and the 67,200,000, take it to our statement under 2019 and 2020 respectively. So I'm going to pick up the figures. I have the 47,400,000, bring it under 2019, and then the 67,200,000 under 2020. And of course, as I've mentioned, the sales, which is the revenue, of course, you may be accustomed to sales. In our statement, we are talking of revenue, which is the same thing. The sales are not affected, as I've mentioned in the previous slide. So next, we proceed to bring in the cost of sales. And of course, between me and you, we are told that the opening inventory, we are told that certain items had been included in the inventory as at 31st of March 2019. All right, the implication of this error is that the cost of goods sold for 2019 do not include the 4.2, because this was taken to closing inventory. Remember, when you're deriving your cost of goods sold, you deduct the closing inventory. So the closing inventory is overstated because these inventories of 4.2 million were actually sold. So it means that the cost of goods sold of 2019 are understated, okay? And then because the closing inventory was carried over to 2020 and included in the opening inventory, it means that the cost of goods sold for 2020 are overstated. So we are going to work out in a note, okay? Going back to our sheet here, we are going to work out in a working one to show the examiner the adjustment that we are going to pass to our cost of goods sold. So if this is my sheet where I'm going to present my notes, I'll straight away, of course, come to working number one, where I'm talking about the cost of goods sold. And in the same vein, I will include a column for 2019, okay? Include for 2019, where I'm going to put the adjustments for 2019 and another column for 2020. So, of course, as stated in the question, we are told, if I can take you back to the question, we are told that the cost of goods sold for 2019 is 34,570,000, and the cost of goods sold for 2020 is 55,800,000. So taking this to my notes, I'll bring the 34,570,000 under 2019 and 55,800,000 under 2020. So I'm going to adjust accordingly, and I bring in the inventory adjustment. Now, as I've mentioned, the cost of goods sold of 2019, we are understated, okay, because this figure was taken in closing inventory. Therefore, I'm going to add the 4,200,000. And at the same time, since these were included in closing inventory, they were carried over to 2020. This figure was carried over to 2020 and therefore included in the opening inventory of 2020. So the implication of that is that the cost of goods sold for 2020 were overstated. So I will deduct the 4.2 inventory adjustment from the cost of goods sold of 2020. So you can make use of your calculators, add the 4.2 on the 34,570,000 and then deduct the 4,200,000 from the cost of goods sold as presented in the question 2020. So my calculator is showing a figure of 38,770,000 when I add to the cost of goods sold for 2019, and I'm getting 51,600,000 the case of 2020. So I'm going to pick up these figures and take them straight to my statement, to my new statement, where I am complying with International Accounting Standard 8. So what I'm going to do, I'll bring the 38,770,000 we have obtained in our working, and then I'll bring in the 51,600,000 as obtained in working number one. Okay, so let us get the new figure. Let us get the new figure for the profit before taxation. And of course, as I'm indicating here, the profit before taxation here is incorrect. So we are going to get new figures. Make use of your calculators. Okay, so try to get 47,400,000 minus 38,770,000, and then again get 67,200,000 minus 51,600,000. All right, so we must be getting a new profit before taxation, and my calculator for 2019 is giving me 8,630,000 and 15,600,000 for the year 2020. So far we have corrected our profit before taxation, and of course we have adjusted the cost of goods sold for the 2 years. So we proceed to the next item, and we are told the next item in our statement of profit or loss is the income taxes. All right, now because the cost of goods sold the cost of goods sold for 2019 were understated, it means that we paid a higher tax, because the reported profit was higher because of that understatement. At the same time, because the cost of goods sold for 2020 were overstated, we paid a lesser tax. So it means that our income tax expense for 2020 was understated. Now we are going to make that adjustment, okay? And of course, below the profit before taxation, I bring in the income tax expense, okay, which needs to be adjusted because of the inventory error. And of course, I'm going to reference my figures to working number two. Take you to the workings here. I bring in working number two for the income tax expense, and of course I need my columns. I need the 2019, okay, shillings in thousands, and I need 2020, again shillings in thousands. So as stated in the question, if I can take you back to the question, as stated in the question, we have income taxes of 3,880,000 for 2019 and 3,400,000 for 2020. So I'm going to pick up those figures and take them to my workings. 2019, I bring in the 3,880,000, and then 2020, I bring in 3,400,000. So the inventory adjustment will come in, as I've mentioned, we have understated income taxes for 2020 and overstated the income taxes for 2019 as per the explanation I've just given. So what I'm going to do, I'll deduct I will deduct 30% of the 4.2. So of course here I'm going to bring the get the 4.2, okay, times 30%, okay, 4.2 times 30%, you'll find that you get a figure of 1.2, okay, which I'm going to deduct from the income tax expense of 1019 and subsequently add to the income tax expense of 2020, because the 2020 income taxes were understated. Okay, so make use of your calculators, get 3,880,000, deduct the 1.2 and get 3,400,000 minus the 1.2. And of course, please don't forget the figures, the 1.2 million, we are getting the inventory error, this 4.2, okay, the 4.2 times the rate of tax given to us, which is 30%. We are given 30% in the question as the income tax rate. If you look at your note number 3, we are given the income tax rate of 30%. So I'm getting 30% times the 4.2 error in inventory, and that gives us the 1.2 that you are seeing right here in my workings. So I know you have got my answers right now. You have got my answers. So let us see. Yes, we are getting 2,620,000 for the year 2019 and 4,660,000 for the year 2020. So you deserve some hand clap there for yourself. Okay, if you have got the figures correct, you deserve a hamper for yourself. So let us pick up these figures. Let us pick up these figures and take them to our schedule. Okay, we pick up these figures. So what are we picking up? We are picking 2,620,000 and taking it to the income taxes of 2019, and 4,660,000 taking it to the income taxes of 2020. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'll bring in the 2,620,000 as an income tax expense for 2019 and 4,660,000 as the income tax expense for 2020. So let's again make use of our calculators. We deduct for 2019, 8,630,000, which is the profit before taxation, minus the income taxes of 2,620,000. Okay. All right. So my calculator is giving me a profit for the period. Okay. Profit for the period. Let me check. Let me see if you are getting the same thing. All right. I'm getting 6,010,000 shillings. Okay. 6,010,000 shillings. At the same time, I want you to deduct 15,600,000, which is the profit before taxation for 2020, minus 4,660,000, which is the income tax expense for 2020 as per working number 2. Okay, let me see. All right, so I'm getting a figure of 10,940,000. So congratulations, we have managed to restate the comparative amount for the prior periods as required by the International Accounting Standard 8. So given the fact that we have restated the comparative amounts for the prior periods, we need to make an adjustment in our statement of changes in equity. We need to make an adjustment in our statement of changes in equity to try and restate the opening balance of the statement of changes in equity. So I'll proceed, of course, to work that one out. And that is minus Uganda Limited. And I have the statement of changes in equity, the retained earnings part. Of course, you know, the statement of changes in equity will capture a number of items. It will have the share capital, it will have the share premium, it will have a column of revaluation surplus, and the retained earnings. And of course, here we are focusing on only the column of retained earnings. Okay, we are focusing on the column of the 10 earnings, and of course I know you should be very well versed with the format for the changes in equity, for the treatment of changes in equity. If you have forgotten the format, please go back, because I don't want you to get lost here. Go back to our lecture, download that video, go back and look at how the statement of changes in equity looks like, especially in regard to the 10 earnings when we have a prior period error. All right, so moving forward, I need a column again for 2019. Okay, I need a column for 2019. I show the shillings in thousands and the precision. And of course, my currency is shillings again for 2020. And all my shillings are in thousands. All right, so I begin by bringing the opening retained earnings. So in our question, they have told us that if you read additional information, Roman 1, they are telling us the retained earnings on the 1st of April 2019, we are 13 million. So I'm going to bring in 13 million just below that 2019. Those are my retained earnings. And now the retained earnings for 2020 are a bit complicated, because remember, we have the opening retained earnings of 2019, which are accumulated to 2020 on addition of the profit for the year. So I will need to show the examiner how I have arrived at the retained earnings, the opening retained earnings of 2020. So I'm going to share with you a very nice and useful note here, or working number 3. Okay, I bring in the working number 3, where I'm going to show the examiner how I've arrived at the retained earnings as at 1st of April 2020. And of course, my shillings will be in thousands, okay? And I'm focusing on 2020. So the retained earnings as at 1st of April 2019, we are told it is 13 million, okay? So I begin with the 13 million, which is our retained earnings at the beginning of the year 2020. And then next, we have the reported profit for the year 2020. Now, which reported profit are we going to take? We are going to take the wrong one, eh? The one in the statement of profit or loss as reported. Okay, so of course the one that is given the statement of profit or loss as reported for the year 2019. So that's the figure I'm going to take and add to the 13 million. Okay, so I'm going to bring in the 8,950,000. Okay, I add it to the 13 million, and definitely that's going to be the opening retained earnings for the year 2020, or the retained earnings as of 31st of March 2020, of course, which will open to the new financial year, 1st of April 2020. So make use of your calculators, find out how much we have here. And of course, my calculator is giving me, is returning a figure of 21,960. So I'm going to pick up this and take it in the place of the retained earnings in my statement of changes in equity working 3. I'm going to put it right here, okay? So that's where I'll put my 21,907,000. Of course, I'm indicating the examiner that please, I have calculated that one in working number 3. So after capturing the opening retained earnings, okay, we now move to bring in the correction of the prior period error. Okay, correction of the prior period. So where am I going to correct this? Of course, not in 2019. You can only put a figure there if the error was in 2018, but the error was in 2019, therefore the correction is made in the year 2020. Now, how much am I going to bring as the correction of the prior period error? So again, I'm going to show the examiner in working number 4 how much is going to be adjusted here. So again, I'm going to share with you another note, another working number 4, correction of the prior period error, how much I brought in. Again, I'm focusing on the year 2020. So, two adjustments have been made, one in the cost of sales and another in the income taxes. So I begin by recognizing the adjustment in the cost of sales, of course, that one is as per working number one, which we saw was a 4,200,000. Of course, we deducted for the case of 2020. And then we have the adjustments to the income tax. Remember what we did under the income taxes? We instead gave an addition. We added 1.2. Do you still recall how we got this? Okay, we got the 4.2. We got the 4.2 times the rate of 30% as given in the additional information. That's how we arrived at the 1.2. So the net adjustment is the negative 4.2 plus the positive 1.2, which definitely is a negative 2,940,000. Negative 2,940,000. So I'm going to pick up this and take it to my statement of changes in equity. Okay, so I'll come to the statement of changes in equity, and then I bring in the 2,940,000. So all in all, I'll have the restated values for the 2 years, 2019, definitely that is the 13 million. And of course, make use of the calculators, find out how much that one is. Okay, find out how much that one is. Yes, my calculator is returning 19,010,000. I don't know what you're getting, but I know you must be getting a similar figure as mine. So we have restated the statement of changes in equity, and therefore now we can recognize the correct profit for the year. So what we are going to do, the profit for the year that we got at the beginning in the correct statement of profit or loss, we are now going to bring it here. So remember, we got 6,010,000. Okay, 6,010,000, and then for 2020 we got 10,940,000. You can check again just from the statement of profit or loss that we have just, not the other wrong one, but now the correct one. These are the two figures we have got, 2019 and 2020. So definitely we have our closing retained earnings, okay? We have our closing retained earnings. Try to make use of your calculators. Our closing retained earnings, all right. So my calculator is returning a figure of 19,010,000 for 2019. And of course, I have closing retained earnings for 2020 of 29,950,000. So congratulations, you have managed to restate the figures for the statement of changes in equity. And of course, this winds up our discussion on correction of prior period errors.